Hi, and welcome to the Mayor's Report. I'm Northampton Mayor David Narkowitz, and this is my monthly program on NCTV where we talk about the issues and projects that we're working on here in the city. Usually when you tune in, I'm in a suit and I'm in an office somewhere, but today I'm actually out in the field. I'm up in Florence on Bliss Street. And some of you may recall that at the beginning of the month in April, I declared war on potholes in the city. We had quite a tough winter with regard to our city streets. A lot of potholes. I know a lot of residents have called in to the city, have used our mobile app to report potholes to the city. So today I thought it would be great to come out onto a city street, join a DPW crew, roll up my sleeves and help them fill potholes, but also talk a little bit about our process for dealing with potholes. So today I'm joined by our street superintendent, Rich Parcelletti. Thanks for being out here today, Rich.
Thank you, Mayor, for coming out today.
And so let's just talk a little bit about potholes. What causes them, and how did this winter, was this winter harder than past winters with regard to potholes?
Well, in regards to what causes potholes, there's varying things that cause potholes, but the major one is the frost that we have in the ground, the freeze and thaw cycle that we have. That can be fine for a brand new road because there are really no open cracks for any water to get in during the wintertime. Mm-hmm. But when you have a road that's older, that has a lot of cracks in it or has previous potholes, the water actually will settle into those holes. It'll freeze overnight and it actually pops the asphalt out, and thus you have a pothole. And this year in particular, because of the depth of the frost and the long duration cold temperatures we had, this season has been probably one of the worst seasons that I can remember in 25 years for pothole damage.
Exactly. And so, and we got a lot of requests for potholes. The city has certainly responded to our call. What would you estimate? I know it's in the hundreds.
I would say we've probably received over 500 work orders at this point. I don't have an actual count. As of today, we have roughly put out almost 400 tons of asphalt since the beginning of April when you declared your war on potholes.
Exactly. So that's pretty much we're now in the last week of April as we're filming that. So that's significant. So how do you, let's talk about the process for how you fill potholes. I mean, the main ingredient you need is asphalt. So how does the DPW deal with asphalt, you know, in the late winter and then as we move into spring?
Well, we have two processes we use. In the fall, we get prepared every year for the winter months when the blacktop plants are closed. We actually make blacktop curbing and we cut it into small cubes. We call them ingots, so like a gold ingot bar, but it's blacktop.
Exactly.
And then we have two units that are trailer mounted units that are hot box reclaimers. Mm-hmm. We actually load about 4 tons of those ingots into the reclaiming unit as a solid, and then we heat them overnight, and the next morning we have hot asphalt. So that process carries us in the winter months up until usually the third or fourth week in March, when the local blacktop plants start to reopen after, you know, things warm up. And then from that point forward, we get HMA or hot mix asphalt from our local plants. There's Warner Brothers, there's Palmer Paving. Those two are the ones that are closest to us that we use. And then use that process, and we use it out of the back of 5-ton dump trucks for the rest of the season.
So you can get a much bigger quantity
with,
as opposed you can get
8 to 10 ton and a drop in the back of a truck, which lasts much longer. And obviously we've had so many large potholes this year that the two hot boxes struggled to actually keep up. The crew used two boxes and they were done by 12 o'clock every day, and some of the days preceding the opening of the blacktop plants.
And so, obviously, one of the big things with so many potholes is having to sort of triage what are the worst ones. And so I'm sure that was also part of the process, going out and just surveying where you needed to strike first when there's particularly ones that could do real damage to people's vehicles.
Yes, and what we ended up doing this year is that we got so many work orders all at one time that I had one individual actually taking the work orders and inspecting all the locations where the work orders were. And then I had two other crews running both hot boxes, patching. So at the end of the day, you know, we had a net amount of potholes that were repaired, plus we also had information about the potholes we're going to tackle the following day. And then when the blacktop plants opened, which allowed me to increase the crews to 3 crews, we ended up actually separating the 3 crews and putting them in the 3 different locations in the city. We lower downtown areas, middle areas in Florence, and the upper areas, up in the Leeds area. Mm-hmm. So those crews have been running independently of each other, but filling potholes basically by starting on the mains and then working into the residential streets.
And the other thing that I announced when I announced the war on potholes was also our plan for the construction season to really try to tackle some of the resurfacing needs, some of the crack sealing needs, in some cases full depth reclamation of some of our streets. And that's really key to potholes because, as you said at the beginning, when you have streets that are decaying, that have cracks, that's what invites the water to getting in there and causing that freeze thaw that causes potholes. So to the extent that we can keep our streets in good shape, keep them free of cracks, that's ultimately going to prevent potholes down the road.
Yeah, I would totally agree with that. A good example of that would be Sylvester Road. Mm-hmm. Last summer, Sylvester Road was completely resurfaced, full depth reconstruction.
Yep.
The prior year before that, we spent probably 3 weeks filling potholes.
Yeah.
3 solid weeks with one crew.
Yep.
So Sylvester Road was, totally repaved, and all that manpower and resources are now directed to other streets.
And this year, Sylvester Road did not have the kinds of problems that you saw last year.
No, not at all. Sylvester Road is in really good shape.
Excellent.
I made it through the winter really well.
I think another example of a street like that is Woodlawn this year, where you had to put fill a lot of potholes on Woodlawn. And so we're going to just go ahead and repave it this year and hopefully have the same result.
Yep, we spent 2 weeks on Woodlawn Avenue solid when we actually had the hot box units, but we kept having to go back there because we were still in the freeze thaw cycle. Mm-hmm. So potholes we filled the previous day had broken back open again the following day.
Mm-hmm. So today I actually got to join the crew and got to help. Wheelbarrow some asphalt around, did a little raking. You guys even trusted me to run the roller a little bit. Kind of brought back childhood memories of running tractors and things like that growing up. Talk about the actual process. How is the crew configured? What kind of equipment do they have? And then how do you fill a pothole? What's the process?
Well, each crew consists of 3 to 4 men that they have a truck, a trailer that houses a roller, and then they have a 5-ton dump truck which ferries the blacktop back and forth from the back blacktop plant.
And today the guys went down to where?
Today we started out at Warner Brothers, but we finished the day at Palmer Paving in East Hampton.
Okay, so they get the asphalt in East Hampton, and then they come out to the street that they want to work on.
Yeah, that's correct. And we typically start out with a six or seven ton drop first thing in the morning to stretch the morning hours, and then we finish off with a 3 or 4 ton drop in the afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
And this year we've been going through the blacktop very quickly, as I said earlier, up to 400 tons so far in less than a month.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the nature of the size of these the size of these potholes. So
yep. Yep.
And you can hear them. I think you can hear them coming down the road right now.
Yes, they are. The crew is coming, the roller's coming. So what exactly happens then? Talk me through what they do when they're out here in the street. They have a bunch of potholes.
What they'll end up doing is they will actually come out to the street. They'll actually clean all the potholes of any kind of debris, other old blacktop or sand or any of the gravelly material that might be in there, so we have a good base to start from. Some of the potholes we actually put a tack coat in them,
mm-hmm.
So we have a little extra adhesion. And then we just fill each single pothole with hot HMA, and then we roll them and move on to the next one.
And I noticed, when you're filling them, you're trying to mound it up enough so that when it gets pressed down, that it doesn't create an indent.
Yeah, that's correct, because some of these potholes are so deep that you're filling multiple layers of old blacktop. It could be anywhere from 4 to 6 inches deep. So when a car will drive on it with its singular tire, it'll mm-hmm. make an impression, so you want to make sure there's enough material in there.
And then the roller obviously is just a way of really tamping it down and applying some good pressure to make sure that it seals.
Yeah, the amount of potholes we have this year, I couldn't imagine not doing without having a roller for each crew.
Okay.
Because the amount of hand tamping would be futile, and it doesn't get the same kind of compaction as a roller does.
Exactly. So, and then the other thing I know that we talked about before was, you only have so much working time with the asphalt when you get it from the plant. So depending on the weather, I know when we first launched the war, Mother Nature kind of fought back a little bit. We had a snow squall that week and we had some freezing temperatures. So that makes it harder to keep the asphalt workable and the amount of load you can actually take.
Yeah, that's correct. We typically get larger loads when the temperature is colder. So we have actually some insulation so the blacktop that's inside the center of the mm-hmm. the drop is hotter, stays mm-hmm. warmer. Mm-hmm. Usually runs about 275 to 350.
Yeah.
Is okay. the optimum temperature.
So I know we've got a lot of other activities to get to this summer, street sweeping, you know, you've got all the other line painting, crosswalks, but right now our focus is on getting all these potholes addressed.
Yeah, that's correct. We have everybody available in the streets division, and I've actually had to utilize employees from other divisions to supplement the crews mm-hmm. in order to make this happen. But I think we're actually...
You even had the mayor working
today. We even had the mayor today, that's
right. Exactly, all hands on deck. And again, I always want to remind people, if you see potholes, because as you know, these things sometimes crop up overnight or potholes, you know, patches fail, etc. You know, contact the DPW. You can go to the website. There's a little button on the left-hand side where you can report a pothole. You can also use the mobile app that you can download. And then you can just call the DPW as well. What's the number that people call when
they can call 587-1570.
Exactly.
And that'll direct you to our hotline for potholes.
Exactly. Exactly. Well, thank you so much for all the work you've done in this war that we're having on potholes. I know it puts a lot of stress on our infrastructure, puts a lot of stress on our manpower, but we appreciate your determination and the determination of your crews to get out there and address these things, because they are a public safety issue. People damage their vehicles, and we want to make sure that our streets are safe and passable. So thanks a lot.
You're welcome. Thank you.
All right. Thanks. And thank you for joining us on the Mayor's Report out here in the field. And as always, if you have any questions about today's episode or you have ideas for future episodes, you can call my office at 413-587-1249, or you can email me at mayor@northamptonma.gov. And as always, our website has all kinds of information about the Department of Public Works and all of our city services. And you can find that on the web at www.northamptonma.gov. Again, I'm Mayor Narkowitz. Thank you so much for tuning in to another episode of the Mayor's Report.